What's up guys, it's Chop from Muc-Off and today I'm going to show you how to clean, protect and lubricate your bike. I've got this filthy Polygon Siskiyou behind me. Let's get to work. The products I'm going to be using today are the 8-in-1 bicycle cleaning kit, the X3 dirty chain machine, the drivetrain cleaner and last but not least, lubricant, our dry lube. So the first thing we're going to do is use our drivetrain cleaner and that's going to get rid of all that thick greasy grime that's around the cassette, around the chain rings and the derailleur, as well as the chain, and that's going to help your gears run smoother. And now it's time to agitate those areas with our claw brush. So this claw here is going to help remove any of the dirt and grime that has lodged itself in between the jockey wheels. And now it's time to use the detailing brush, which is ideal for your chain, cassette and chainring. Now it's time to give your chain a thorough clean and we're going to be using the X3 dirty chain machine. So to remove the X3 machine, simply remove the clip and clip it from there and that's it. Look at all that grime. Now I'm going to rinse off the drivetrain and pre-rinse the entire bike ready for a clean. Now we've pre-rinsed the bike, it's time to use our Nanotech bike cleaner. This is going to get your bike looking box fresh again. So now our bike is completely covered with our bike cleaner, it's time to use our soft wash brush to clean the entire bike. And what this is going to do is help remove all of that dirt and grime and not damage any of the paintwork. Next up we have our sponge, which is ideal for your handlebars and your small components like your levers and also areas like your steer tube under here as well. Let's get to work. And next up we have our two-prong brush and this is going to help get to those hard to reach areas like your hubs, your rims and your seat stay and cranks. So now our bike is completely clean, it's time to rinse it off. Now we've rinsed the bike, it's time to protect our bike with our Bike Protect. And what this is going to do is help drive out any moisture and leave a protective layer in between washes. We have disc brake covers on, but if you don't, just avoid spraying on any braking surfaces. Now our bike is protected, it's time to lubricate our bike with dry lube. Apply dry lube to the lower part of the chain and let gravity feed it into each link, and that's going to help all the drivetrain run as smooth as possible. So the difference between dry lube and wet lube is simple. Dry lube is for dry conditions and wet lube is for wet conditions. And that is how you clean, protect and lubricate your mountain bike, which is going to make it last longer. Thanks for watching.